crazy. Oh yeah.
I love how you guys made it say warm up, lol.
So I gave Eric a warm up, so let's see if he plays it. It's a good map. Will knows the map. But...
I can probably unmute for at least the intro, so it's not a nothing big deal. You guys will we'll figure it out.
Pretty sure I recall Ermi's maximum being like a high 5-star map, so nicely played by both players. Pretty great max combo on the side of Voss as well on this warm-up.
Oh wait, was that Ambi's warm-up? Oh, unlucky.
Oh my god.
He's doing the crazy frog medieval cover warm up. The technology.
Oh my lord, it's Axel F.
Oh my god.
Nice.
That is unholy.
You know, I remember having a crazy frog CD as a kid.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That is. That's like an artifact. They're gonna dig up in like 2,000 years.
This is so true.
How much are you gonna resell it for? How much are you hankering it goes on now?
Well, I had it as a kid. I actually don't know if we even have it anymore. So if it's just randomly sitting somewhere in our storage, then maybe someone will dig it up. Or maybe it's actually just not even at my place anymore. I genuinely just haven't seen it in years.
There's a chance that this crashes stream. If this is this map that crashes stream, or crashes the client, I'm gonna be mad. So.
I mean, okay. Rule number one of warm-ups, never let them play halftime.
It's just
halftime
easy.
Breaks way too hard. Easy mod will be fine, but halftime, for some reason, tournament client does not like halftime.
I feel like tournament client just hates either of the speed mods, to be honest.
I do notice it break more on DT than no mod, actually, now that I think about it.
AR 3.75? Let's go.
Oh no. AR 3.75, okay, so they're just gonna be flailing.
Yeah, yes. They're gonna attempt to play to the crazy frog beat. Oh god. At least it's not hidden. It's getting audio from then, probably.
Yeah, turn down the audio from Wass's client. Or you could...
What? Wait, check your mixer.
Alright, panic button.
Yeah, they are.
Classic.
This is so... Stream can't see it. Oh, unlucky. Great. Crazy Frog broke the stream. Let's go. This is quite the warm up. It's like 80% done. GG. Five rolled by Waz. Let's see if AMB can beat that. 13, big. Let's see if AMB decides to take first pick or first ban. I don't know if it's showing correctly. Yeah, it's not showing correctly on stream, by the way. It's double AMB. First ban. So we're gonna see second pick from AMB. Probably gonna ban Hidden and then Fremont if I had to guess. But we'll see. Nomad too, getting the stream out of there. That's also a pretty good ban out of AMB. See what it was. Decides to ban now. Probably Hard Rock and then maybe a DT or a skill set that he's weaker at. Let's see. Hard Rock 2 and Fremont 2. Okay, so yeah, the anti mod and one of the Hard Rock, the small circle size Hard Rock.
So basically, both small circle size Hard Rocks in the event that they would prefer to do small circle size Hard Rock over low AR Hidden on the anti mod.
Yes. The crazy frog in the background going crazy. DT2. Okay, so getting the speed out of there. Is that speed in this? Yes, it is. Oh, maybe not. No, it streams. Okay, getting the DT streams out. See what Wasp goes for. First pick.
Oh, and it'll be birds.
Yep, no 1-4. It's the tech pick, yeah.
Because big sliders, they so good.
True. So we saw this in our last semifinal, or last match earlier today, and it was pretty interesting. Lots of, like, obviously big sliders and a lot of intermediate notes between those sliders that you have to alt to hit. So we'll see how the players fare on those. Early ACK advantage for AMB, but both players comboing through this beginning section. There's the first break out of AMB. There's another break out of Waz though, so a combo reset. Both players super close in their scores now since the ACK gap has kind of shortened.
Oh, Wasp gonna miss once more.
He's ahead in score right now. With getting
that'll bounced. Slowly change as AMB still holds combo advantage of about 50.
Yeah, as we can see now, third of the way through the map, slight score lead, but we do see the combo drop there. So Wasp able to take back some of that at disadvantage now, and then breaks. Man. This is still anybody's map halfway through. AMB holding a slight lead right now, though. Still only 20k separating these players with a third of the map left. Neither one of them really holding combo, but was holding a slight combo advantage here. Might be able to bring that gap back. Needs to see a miss out of AMB though. Both players missing there. And the accuracy might be enough to just carry AMB.
Still close, however.
Yeah.
But neither player can hold combo now.
Yeah. Both of them missing. Ak is still in favor of AMB as well. About 20k score difference. And yeah, that's going to be AMB's map. Winning on his opponent's pick for the first map. That's off to a good start for him. So probably going to dip into the hard rocks, I assume, early, especially wanting to probably push the advantage while he has it. Could go for something like a more consistency pick or maybe a slower pick, especially since nerves might be a factor at the very beginning of the match. But we do see the hard rock consistency, so... One of AMB's strong points, I think Waz didn't do that great on his hard rock and qualifiers. But this is definitely AMB favored. Hard rock. You have to do a space. A lot of two maps banned. Getting into it here. Early break out of Waz. Let's see if he can combo through, and it's about a 6%, 5%. That gap is closing though. Ak advantage for AMB right off the gate. Definitely not the biggest deal, but that another break out of Waz. Well, AMB is still just comboing through this early section of the map. Ooh, hitting those jumps on AMB. Quarter way through the map, we can see AMB is much more confident in the hard rock than Waz. Still holding combo on A and B. Pretty good accuracy too, 95% here. See if we can get an FC on a hard rock pick. That would be really cool to see, to be honest. I don't know how much he practiced it, but we can probably assume that he practiced it a decent amount.
Yeah, this is a very good showing. Oh man, B, it looks like he did practice this map pretty well. I mean, this is his first pick, so I'd hope he'd be pretty confident on it.
Yeah. Yeah, this is... I don't even know if Wasp can come back in this this map, but all eyes on A and B now, essentially. Oh, he does find the break, though. Yeah.
Even with the break, it's still looking like an extremely strong pick for A and B. Just doing better than Wasp in virtually every department.
Man, if he gets a one miss, that'd be tragic.
This is on triple.
But yeah, an extremely strong hard rock showing coming out of AMB. As expected though. We'll have to see what Wasp responds with. Early 2-0 lead for AMB here. But it is 1-7, so best of 13, I believe. Yeah. See what he goes for here. Maybe another Nomad, or... Yeah, Nomad 1, so going for that kind of coin flippy consistency pretty early into the match here. We saw this picked in our last match, Mr. Chicken versus Chikorita, and Mr. Chicken did lose that pick, so this is it's just a standard Nomad one, I think, for the most part.
I honestly can't really see a world where Nomad 1 will end up being as one-sided as Hard Rock 1.
Yeah, definitely.
There is a chance that the general aim difficulty will still be there, and it possibly being... I mean, Wasp was the one to pick Nomad 1, so I'd imagine that they've thought about this at least a bit.
Yeah.
Like, regardless of the fact that AMB just beat them on what was essentially a Hard Rock aim map, the AR difference could actually end up making a huge difference in comfort.
Yes, exactly. Tough to see, because if somebody takes an early miss on this map, it's gonna be bad. It's gonna be hard for them to come back, maybe, depending on if the other player can combo through. Neither one of them have done that though, and they're holding combo. Ak is pretty even as well, so we'll have to see. They both look pretty comfortable though, on this map so far. Getting to this first little jump section. Both hitting it. Oh, that's a miss out of what? Oh, both of them missing. Whoa. That's a lot of misses coming out of AMB.
Yeah, AMB seemed to miss an entire section there.
Maybe a no-locked or something, but Waz also took a miss on that burst. Feel extremely close. Both players missing again, or maybe...
I think that could have been Client. I have no clue what they could have missed on there because they hit that burst.
No, they... doesn't seem like it. Both of them just missing there.
To be fair, I have seen Bancho, like, take a whole minute and then, like, refresh the combo of a player.
Yeah, I think looking at it in the lobby, though, it's still both of them holding the same combo, basically.
Ah, nice.
Oh yeah, both of them missing on the exact same pattern. Assuming those letter ends dropped, is currently on equal combo.
And it's now actually Wasp with a slight ACK advantage halfway into the map.
Yeah. So, translate to about a 20k score advantage, but definitely not insurmountable, especially since he takes a miss there. AMB still holding. That could be bad. Oh, but there's the break. Wow.
That'll and keep Wasp in the lead for now.
Yeah, he held accuracy through that, where AMB dropped out of percentage.
And when the scores are this close, accuracy will make a huge difference.
Wasp taking another break, though. Ooh. This actually is going to come down to the wire here.
AMB does have enough time.
Yeah. Oh,
they missed on the square jumps.
What happened there? Maybe another note lock, or it looks like he aimed it correctly. L.
L. Back to the start and stop jumps. AMB going to be the first one to miss, helping Wasp to maintain the lead.
Yeah.
Only got about 20 seconds left to be able to hold on, and ahead by 60,000 points on AMB.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough now for AMB to come back into this map. But there's a break. Don't think it's enough time. Very close map between these players, though. And now we're back to AMB's pick.
Lost getting themselves in the leaderboards. Or on the board. The board.
Yep. Now 1-2. This is, you know, still early into the match. If AMB loses on this pick, then, you know. But if he can maintain his advantage by just winning on his own picks, that's... the match secured, but obviously things don't always go to plan, especially in the later half where you might not have as many picks that you're confident on. See if he takes the
I'm also gonna grab a water break. Loss is a good point.
I don't know. I feel like when I pick this map, there maybe the jumps were a little too hard. A lot of people are struggling on this map.
Let them struggle on the Nomad one, it makes it more exciting.
That's
the first player to miss doesn't just lose.
I was gonna interject here and say Nomad 1's been picked every single match in this round. So epic. So epic.
True.
I mean, it's a good map. People love this song.
A good song, too.
Good
yeah.
Song.
It is a little difficult. The jumps. Right,
HR3. Oh yeah, so taking the other Hard Rock pick instantly. He's gonna have to go into something else after this, since Hard Rock 2 is banned. I haven't seen this one yet. Is this what is this? Is this Hard Rock 3? Oh, Hard Rock Sliders. Wow, okay. We'll have to see. Oh. Alan out here with the extremely professional ban and pick showing. Looks like the players are ready for this. Or, well, one of them is. I don't know if AMB is back yet. I don't know if he took a break. Anyways, definitely an AMB favored map. All of these hard rock picks are very AMB favored, but maybe Waz like practiced it a bunch, and it's sliders, so you know, sliders are kind of RNG sometimes, depending. I don't know this map very well, so I'll have to see. Getting into Hard Rock 3 here, by the way.
Oh yeah, I've seen this map, the HR tech of this pool, I'd assume. Mm-hmm. And considering Wass's overall confidence with Hard Rock and HR 1, I think I could imagine why AMB would want to go with this map.
Yeah. Both players holding combo, though.
The intro's just looking shaky accuracy-wise for Wass, but...
Here we get to the first draw. Almost. Yep, here we go. Still holding.
This is epic.
Yeah, this is pretty impressive.
Ooh, AMB's gonna actually be the first one to miss. Followed sharply by Lawless, and
this is really close. So 10% accuracy, but scores.
It's just neither player managing to hold good enough accuracy to maintain what you'd typically expect out of V2 scores for the combos they've been setting.
Yeah. But the rest hold comboing through the slow section as well. Both of them improving the rack as well. So about a 50k score beat for AMB here in the last quarter-ish of the map. We'll have to see. I don't know if that's enough time. He has to break soon, though. And there it is. There's the break. Let's see if Wallace can take... Oh, he also breaks, though. If they both combo through, it's going to be AMB's map, but it's still extremely close, and there's a break out of Wallace, so... I think that might seal it here.
The accuracy for AMB just too good. Comparatively in this. Oh, it's... Yeah, it's a 50k advantage now for AMB. Map's pretty much over.
Yep,
so that looks like a sealed deal.
And AMB's gonna go up 3-1 here. Both players only miss... having 5 misses. Let's see what Waz responds with here.
Happy to see that Wass is super happy with their play. At the end of the day, I'd say that that's one of the most important things that matter.
Exactly. Nomad 5 speed. Interesting. This is the first speed pick of the... Well, I don't think we had a speed pick in quarterfinals, so... The first time speed has been introduced into this pool. We haven't seen it out of either player yet so far in this tournament. So, be very interesting to see how they do.
So my understanding is that they're basically going into uncharted territory.
Yes. And while AMB isn't like a stream player, I don't know if Wass is a speed player. And obviously streams are different than bursts. And we're going to see primarily bursts in this map. 230 BPM, so fairly fast. I don't know if either one of them are single tapping these. I think they're both alting it. Yeah, they are. Neither one of them looking super confident on it so far. I won't lie. But now they have some combo. AMV breaks right as I say that. There goes Floss. Oh, AMV is trying to single tap through this. So, maybe adapt it a little bit to it. Neither player really able to hold combo or accuracy on this pick. Quarter way through the map.
In situations like these, I feel like you as the player in the position would be like, man, I'm doing like really like bad or stuff. And you'd start beating yourself up and be like, man, I feel like I'm like not even playing that well. And then you're going to just see the end result and be like, wait, I won.
Wait, I wonder what his scores look like in practice, on what either player, either of these players' scores look like in practice.
See, that's assuming that they're not side rating.
Yeah, well, both of them had the map, so...
Oh, okay.
Probably not side reading. Also, AMB did react in chat when it was picked, so... Still. I wonder if Waz is just that confident in... AMB's inability to play... streams or speed?
Well, it's working.
Yeah, it is working.
Boss is gonna miss, but did manage to hold into the hundreds of combo there. That'll further increase their lead against AMB.
Yeah, only about a third of the map left here, and 40k score gap, but usually that wouldn't be too crazy if either player had combo or accuracy, but...
But this time, it's huge, because, like, that's... Waz is beating AMB by double of AMB's points and then some. Proportionally speaking, this is a huge victory for Waz.
Yeah, and he's actually holding... Oh, okay, well.
No, Waz taking it off of just being able to hold combo for slightly longer than AMB more frequently throughout the map, plus the 84 ACK comparatively to 75.
Yeah.
Looking pretty strong for them.
Yeah, exactly. Well, and now that the Hard Rock pool is gone, we'll have to see what AMB dips into now. We have the entirety... Well, yeah, we have the entirety of the hidden pool available. And...
I think another thing worth noting about the Nomad 5 is that it's 230 BPM. Mm-hmm. And so... I know a lot of speed players that like will be really good up to certain BPMs and then they'll just go from 100 to 0 soon as the BPM gets slightly too high. So this might just be like a little too high out of their range. Like if it was a 220 BPM speed map, then hypothetically they would have been performing a lot better. Because it depends on the player, honestly. The 230 is, you know, pretty high BPM wise for I'm pretty sure it's like a 5.9 pool.
And we see that I got hit with Mega Nerves. So we can kind of assume that maybe that wasn't his best play on the map.
Nerves will make any skill set more difficult in match, so understandable.
Let's see. I'm guessing we'll see a free mod pick here out of AMB.
My arm was a whole rock there. Alright.
Yeah, we do see free mod one.
Ooh, this is a very old map, to my knowledge.
Hysteria? Yes, I believe it is. Oh. Yeah, this was ranked in October of 2014.
If I had to describe this map, I would say that it is, to some extent, also speed, but it's more of just speed aim, and also awkward aim, I would say. Like, it's basically going to be like, if you look at these jumps, they're going to be pretty small, like, compared to, like, something like a Nomad 1. But you gotta keep in mind, this is on 210 BPM, and also that the angles for all the jumps in this map are significantly less comfortable than the average Nomad 1 jumps.
Right. And I'm expecting we see Hard Rock out of AMP, and I don't know what boss is going to take. Maybe Hidden? I'm not sure. I think the free mod broke though, Alan.
Yep. Yep. Oh yes, you should probably just get them both to take no fail. Just like, I would say that to players that are FCing. Like, you never know what'll happen. Especially because this is an old map, so I don't... Actually, wait, what am I saying? Watch the HP drain just be listed on the sheet. Oh, no, it's not. Okay. Well, it's an old map, so if it's like HP 7 or higher, then like 100%, like literally the smallest of things could make people fail.
I'm not gonna spoil, but that's a very interesting thing that I'm looking at in the lobby right now.
Interesting, okay.
Yeah.
Because I'm just saying, actually no, I'll bring it up. Easy mod is doable on this map, simply because it's old style.
Did MP map time?
I doubt either of these players will go easy mod, but
no.
I'm just saying that is on the table, probably.
Yeah, and so we see Hidden Hard Rock coming out of walls here.
Ooh. Interesting.
Wow, dropping a lot of... Whoa. Is that just client?
Oh. High chance it was client.
Yeah, this looks very doable, Hidden Hard Rock, to be honest. I wonder how much practice was put in on the 2 mod on this. Maybe just trying to get the straight up multiplier advantage? So far, though.
Could just be a preference for Hidden Hard Rock over Hard Rock. I've met at least a few people that prefer it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know what AR this is without Hard Rock. I think it's 9?
It's probably 9 flat.
9.2.
Ooh.
So yeah. That's not too bad with just straight up hidden, but some players just prefer the AR10 hidden. But AMB looking super confident on this, holding 97 ACK. Oh, there's a break though. This is still anybody's map. Wallace is holding a good amount of combo here. And Omni breaks. Kind of unfortunate. Players able to see each other's scores there, so see the UGG coming out of Waz, so obviously not super happy about that. Oh, missing that triple. I don't know if he tapped it incorrectly or if he moved off it too fast, but that's unfortunate. AMV is looking super good on this pick. Yeah, just holding that 95% accuracy in the combo advantage. He's double lost the score here. Hitting that stream as well. This is AMB's pick though, so. Yeah, okay. And yeah, it's gonna be AMB's map. He looks really strong on that pick with the hard rock. Incredibly unhappy with that play though, so if the nerves got to him a little bit, you can definitely mess up on hidden hard rock. DT1. Alright, get some DT consistency. Saw this map played earlier today. It's 215 BPM. So. Foreground eclipse, huh? Interesting. That makes sense. He can be glad that it wasn't his pick that he lost on. one of them just doesn't have the background. It's pretty interesting, but
yeah, I noticed that earlier. I just didn't call it out. Like, it's not showing backgrounds. I saw it lag a bit during Hysteria.
Oh, wow. We see AMV holding the SS here, though. That is... on it. Oh, there. Well, there's the drop, the SS. But still, this is pretty unexpected.
Wait.
Holding, still holding insane ack. This is Wallace's pick, so...
yeah. That's very unexpected.
Yeah.
Working out well for them. And this is like
hitting that
boost. Oh, it's 214.
Yeah.
I mean, well, there's A and B first miss, but
both players breaking there though. Still, that's a pretty substantial ack and combo gap that A and B was able to make in the first half of this map. See if Waz can bring it back in the second half here. Oh, I see a little bit of break from both players on that stream, that burst. But AMV holding the substantial score lead here, with about a third of the map left to play, get to the break in the map. So another break out of Waz, that's probably it. AMV still holding combo into the end of this map, but really both players mess up on that. Oh, Waz gives up. No.
I think Waz might have just seen leaderboard and knows.
Yeah. It is going to be AMV winning on Waz's pick, though. So, again, going to give himself another advantage here. A lot of wiggle room. He only needs two more maps to clinch this match, so... let's see what he goes to now. We'll have to see if he goes back to the free mods, or if he goes into one of the no mods. See if the hidden pool is just completely ignored in this match.
That is a good point. We have yet to see a hidden in this match.
Hasn't even been banned out. I mean, it's completely open. So.
Yep. Implying that neither person is like super afraid of the other on hidden.
I don't think either one of them are super confident on hidden either. So. And I think they both know that, though.
If they both take the rule that says that you can just do no mod instead of hidden for, like, reduced multiplier,
yeah,
then they're basically just both playing each other on no mod. Like, there's no point even calculating the qualifier. It's literally just a no mod map.
Yep. And we did see AMB take that on at least hidden 2 in qualifiers. I don't know if I was. I don't remember if he took no mod on that. Taking his time with this pick, so he's definitely maybe towards the end of his picks that he's thinking of, or maybe not super confident going into the hiddens.
Well, the longer the match goes, the less options they'll have. Oh, pains me to do this hidden one.
Hidden consistency. All right. Let's see if they take no out on it.
As soon as I saw it pains me to do this, I felt the hidden pool being dived into. Yep.
Oh,
with
no
hidden.
Oh, wow. So we just get another no mod one.
I mean, as I mentioned earlier, if both of them don't use hidden, then we don't need to calculate a multiplier.
Yeah, exactly. But honestly, we saw Waz won the Nomad one pick. So if he takes hidden and AMB doesn't, then that could be really bad for AMB. Okay, Waz is going to play hidden. So we'll see. This is going to be a very interesting map. Do no fail and then free mod. I think Alan. Or just free mod. Got it.
Oh, thanks for letting us know.
You said 0.75, right?
Yeah, it's 0.75.
Okay.
We saw this in our last match as well, Chikorita versus Mr. Chicken, and Chikorita asserted her hidden dominance on this map, so. We see the early ACK advantage coming out of the no mod player. But again, that's that 0.75 multiplier on his score. We saw it come into play last match as well, where Chikorita lost a mat because of that multiplier. Right now we see the combo and ACK advantage for AMB, but if Waz can keep this combo and stay around this accuracy, that could mean that he just wins off multiplier. Oh, but there's the break. Unfortunate.
And with that, AMB will begin to run away with it.
Mm-hmm.
But still early in the map.
Yep. Only almost a third of the way through. I think right now we're hitting a third of the way. At 5% accuracy. though. Of the way, or a quarter of the map left. Both players holding some combo, but Wallace has the score advantage by about 70k right now. Yep, it looks like it's gonna be Wallace's victory here on Nomad 3. Now we're back to AMB's pick, still on match point, so we'll see what he goes for here. None of the free mods left, none of the hard rocks left. We have, I think, one DT left, and two hiddens, and I think one or two, no mods. No, we have no mods left, sorry. Two hiddens, one DT, and that's it. Yeah. Two hiddens and one DT. We'll have to see what AMB goes for out of those.
Yeah, no, I don't think any of these picks now, especially AMB already said that he didn't even want to do HD1.
Mm-hmm.
But after that last showing, maybe he might pick HD3.
Yeah, we'll see.
No mod again, but that actually might just scare Wasp to go no mod.
DT3 is the speed pick. There's a DT4 in this pool.
HD3.
My bad. There is two DTs left. There's a DT4.
Okay, free mod three. This is the alt pick, I believe. The alt free mod.
Oh yeah, there were more maps. Sorry, than I thought left. Yes, this is, I believe, alt. Yes. Free mod alt. Let's see. Does Wasp go for hidden hard rock again? And does AMB want to alt hard rock? And no spoilers because it's not locked in, but that might be what we're seeing.
I'm gonna interject here and say I'm a sinner. I single tap this map actually. It's
yeah.
That's why I put it in the pool. Cause it's single tappable.
You are.
I'm a sinner. What can I say? Alright.
Terrible.
Alright, well, we're gonna move on. Old map time.
Alright.
Old map. And yeah, it looks like it's gonna be the same mods as the last free mod. Hidden is my mortal blow. Yes.
I'll help step in with commentary on this one too, so. Alright, so.
This is amazing.
This is a good map. I like this map. It's almost like I put it in the pool.
It's 4.5 minutes long, so.
Yeah. I was expecting Wasp to take HDHR on this one because in his scrim against Allen, he did take this mod combination and barely won out against Allen. So
yeah, I was very shocked when I was when he put HD on in this pick. But this map is pretty comfy for the most part. Like, but it's very easy to like get caught off guard just because you're playing freaking HR as both these are. Like, if you're not used to old-style maps, this is 2011, I believe.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Are there any like full stack triples in it that might trip the hidden player up? Or
there's a couple of weird triples in the map. That's all I'll say.
Yeah, there are weird triples, but it's not like full stack.
As you can see,
really old.
If you look at
2009 full
if you look
stack
at how triple. AMBBB Eric is playing, he is single tapping the whole map. Yeah. He is also a sinner.
I would probably do that too if I was playing this, because 230 is not that bad a single tap.
Yeah, still a little bit comfy.
Yeah. But it's just like on HR, like on speed harder. Of HR is kind of,
We're gonna see the score lead swing here.
It's starting to swing slowly to Wasp, but the first weird part is coming up, the weird triple into singles. It's definitely something that can trip players a lot.
Yeah, it really does.
Oh, look at that, it got Wasp, but did not get AMB, surprisingly. The finger control required for that one part is kind of significant. Not gonna lie. At least, especially if you're ulting. If you're single tapping, it's not as significant.
Slider broke, wow.
But that slider break from AMB means that Wasp has a little bit more wriggle room to work with right now. But that break from Wasp might be a little concerning.
Yeah, the score multiplier really is where most of this lead is
from.
He
drew the OMG.
They see each other's scores a bit.
It's really close, indeed. It is.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Watts is just gonna have
oh, that slider
here.
Break. It's
every
a...
map he just loses.
Oh, no.
If he just messes up once, he's gonna just lose a set.
Yeah. It's all about making less mistakes than your opponent. You can mess up, but you gotta mess up not in a terrible fashion, I guess.
Yeah. And we saw the break there out of Watts, but now he's been comboing, and you have to think, like, mentally, like, you know, that's stressful, messing up. And then, oh, he messes up here again. Hopefully, it just doesn't go into chain tilt.
All right. Yeah, well, they hope both get the slow stream.
We don't know. He could also be having the opposite effect. He might be just straight up honed in.
Yes. Yep.
Like normally, if I'm like backs against the wall, I'm usually just I put my mind to it rather than like get really tilted.
Both players holding about equal combo, and wait, AMB has the act disadvantage now.
Oh, but Wasp breaks right there. That is a little tragic, actually.
That's gonna make this anybody's math now.
Oh, that is really concerning. Oh, they see, too.
Break.
That is concerning.
Now, if you're AMB, you're thinking to yourself,
you have to hold this. You have to hold.
To hold this.
Yeah. And Wasp is just praying for him to slip up. He cannot. He has to take this opportunity. Oh, Wasp misses right there, and AMB is trying to pull it.
And this is the hard part of the map too, so holding here is pretty crazy right now.
And that's
AMB breaks! Oh my god! Oh, he's making it interesting! No. He's making it
it's
interesting!
It's so close. The HD is at the huge difference maker right now.
Wasp is kind of running away with the lead right now, but the end of the map is a bit more difficult than the beginning. It's a lot more spaced out.
We're about 5k between these players or less.
They're hitting it, though.
The next break, oh my god. Wasp is gone.
Oh my gosh, if AMB combos.
AMB can pull us back as long as he doesn't screw up. Oh my god, Wasp is flubbing.
We're coming to the very end now. This might be it.
All
hell breaks loose.
10k. Wasp. Is it enough time? AMB
is feeling it, dude. He's feeling it. He's going. If AMB breaks, it will spell disaster, but he holds just barely.
Wow.
Oh my god. Wasp is gonna kick himself when he sees this dude. That is so frustrating.
What a close map. What an extremely close map. And that's gonna be the win for AMB.
Are we gonna say it? Who's gonna be the one to say it?
I don't know what you want me to say, buddy. What? Oh my god, dude. Who's gonna say it? Alan, you got it. Alright, well.
If you'd like to interview.
The both players can also play the tiebreaker if they wish to, but I think we can do interview first and then tiebreaker showcase if they want to. Or maybe they can do tiebreaker first. Whatever works. Man, that is like... That was down to the wire on that one. AMV had to just push and put himself together for that. Holy lord. Ah. AMV fans coming out in the crowd. Good stuff. I did see there were some Wasp fans in the chat too. It was a valiant effort. Wasp improved a lot over the course of the tournament, honestly. He shouldn't be too sad. He might be a little bit disappointed with how he did on a couple of these maps, because I definitely know, especially something on like DT1 or maybe even Fremont 1, he was like, could have done it. And especially Fremont 3 too, that is a heartbreaker, just seeing how close you guys were.
Yeah. It looks like we're going to be playing tiebreaker here. It's a 5 minute long map. I might have to dip.
Yeah, it's okay. I will, we'll take over the commentary stuff if you have to dip tiebreaker. It was a pleasure.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
It was a pleasure casting today.
Yeah.
So I'll be back tomorrow to cast.
See you, maybe. Dude. Good luck, we'll good luck you, with though. Your assignments and shit, bro. Get that, bro. Alright, well, it's just me and Alan. And AMB is taking Hidden on this one. How do you feel about the outcome of the match, Alan?
Actually, really, even though Watts lost, against me, he did better on pretty much every map that we played together.
You think if that performance came out today, it would have been like a lot, it would be like a lot closer, probably, right?
No, he did better against me. He did better
just
today.
In general? Oh, he did better today. Oh.
Yeah.
He said, by the way, next time we play, I'm winning. Okay, I like that attitude.
Well, that's a good showing.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good showing from Watts.
AMB's just got it, dude. He knows these maps now.
Yeah, he really... I think that Nomad, that using Nomad on...
On Hidden?
On that Hidden one was very good.
Yeah.
I think that really...
You have to take advantage of what you can do. Regardless of how degenerate it may look to people, you have to do what you gotta do to win, dude.
Honestly, I would have done the same thing.
I would have done the same thing on every Nomad pick. Taking Hidden on a Nomad, I would do the same thing. Especially on DT picks too, where the AR is just... Wow, it's a lot of things. But we're jumping into tiebreaker. Both of them going Hidden. Okay. Both of them flexing their Hidden a little bit. This is a kind of a strange map to do it on because this is a tech map. Very techy, bursty map.
Yeah, this map is very, like...
It's techy. Hard.
There's, like, a lot of triples. There's also pretty... There's some screams.
Yeah, the sliders are pretty intense. Big slider drops, a lot of kick sliders. Yeah, you get the deal, boys.
Yeah, but for now, it's pretty comfy. But...
Wasp with the first break. What if AMV was an actual hidden player, dude? He just had it in him. Look at him.
Oh my god, look at that stream. He did
he's
it.
He's moving him. He's moving his body, bro. He's moving his body.
His streams are freaking crap.
It's so
right there.
It's so crisp and clean. Wasp is struggling a little bit, but their acts have evened up.
Well, you're about to get into the drop.
Oh, both of them missing right there.
Yeah, that cut stream is not fun.
Yeah, okay, well, now this has swung entirely into Wasp's favor. Yeah, AMV, not the... I guess I understand him now. Hidden is not fun if you're not used to it. especially on a map like this where you're not already not comfortable with a lot of these patterns and how to tap him. It's even more of a work.
Yeah, this map on Nomad was already freaking super hard.
Yeah.
Because I remember playing it yesterday. And I just like, I did pretty bad. This map is
it's crazy hard. But that's how tiebreaker should be. So
yeah.
Okay, but looking ahead, we have one last match left of this round of semifinals, and that
we
will
don't
be.
Don't know when they
reschedule it for tomorrow at 5 p.m. 5 or 7 p.m. I think it's 5 p.m. actually. Yeah.
All right.
Wasp with the question mark. Yep, Kyle 3MS versus DMGM. So that match will be one of the most interesting matches of the tournament, I feel like. Richard made the bold claim that that is most likely going to be a grand finals too. So I can't guarantee anything yet because there's some hot players. There's still some hot players remaining. Like Richard definitely underperformed a bit last match because of his mouse, but I'm sure he can get up there. And Chikorita is just crazy. Just a crazy player.
Yeah, very, very consistent. Just gapped by no mod.
Yeah, gapped by approach circles, dude. That shit sucks. But
yeah.
But yeah, it would not be an unfair assumption to say that those two would be meeting again in grand finals after the next match. But it's also, but you can't really count out any of the, especially the other top seeds too. The top half is just crazy good. So.
Yeah. And the thing about it is that both of those players we know nothing about.
I got the gist of how 3MS plays. He's definitely more of a skill up kind of guy right now. He performs really well. He will perform really well in higher sword pools, that's for sure. But there's one thing to note is nerves have played a really big issue in his performance so far in the tournament. He is pretty disappointed with some of his qualifier results, and in this match against Parkman 123, he's also disappointed with some other things he pulled out. Just not being able to be as consistent as his counterparts, and yeah.
Yeah, I think he's definitely gonna scale up just because as you get through the tournament, you just get more and more like acclimated to what you need to do.
Yeah.
And everything, so I think it'll be okay.
Yeah, I think his nerves will settle down and he'll be a scary player to face for anybody in the tournament, but you know.
Especially because, like, I believe this is his first tournament, so.
Yeah. So he's fighting those nerves really hard. He has his friends watching, probably gonna flame him if he misses even one note, so. That could definitely be a mental barrier. But yeah, we're getting to the last part of this. Neither of them are hidden players, that's for sure.
Yeah, they're not.
Wasp will win the mental victory of knowing he can play hidden better than AMV, I guess. But yeah. As the match concludes, good stuff to AMV for advancing. He will be facing the loser of DMGM versus 3MS, while Wasp is unfortunately eliminated. But good run by him. Good run by him. He had a lot of potential upset. He just could not close it out on a couple maps. And that just happens. Especially because this is his first tournament. So. Alright, but yeah, next match. Tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. You don't want to miss it, boys and girls. You don't want to miss that shit. will be an exciting match for sure.
They should be coming in then. I'm gonna do it.
You're gonna do it? Okay. Go ahead, Alan.
I'll do it.
Go ahead, Alan. All you. You can put on a song if you want for interview, by the way. Any song you want.
I literally just left.
Oh.
I should have put on K-pop. Oh well.
This stream would have been muted. Alright. Who is that?
Hello. Right.
We got Loss.
And we got one more. Did AMB say he's coming in?
Yeah. Just message him saying to join if he wants to anyway.
Anyway, what's up?
Oh gosh.
I'm sorry.
Who started the WhatsApp, dude? Who started that? Who started it? Was it Ryan?
Someone in the Stone Ages.
Okay, but that match is concluded. How do you guys feel? How's the overall tournament experience? Just because that was, especially for Fremont 3, that was kind of an ass clenching match, dude. It's a lot closer than it should have been.
Yeah, Nomad. Oh, you said Nomad 3 or Fremont 3?
Fremont 3, I meant. Fremont 3.
Oh yeah, Fremont 3, that one was fucking stressful. I was like, that's about like my peak for single tapping because I'm old ass man. So I, like in the last half of the map, had like come together and not griefed up. I think the last half is when I got like my two big combos.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you started, that's when you started like going.
You just pretty went much, and like, went.
Comboing it. Mm-hmm. And yeah, you took the lead during that time. Yeah, so I believe you picked, what was it? Nomad you pick for HD 1, you pick no mod. And actually, what were you thinking? You think that you're just straight up just better?
I had played it like once or twice. I didn't get a lot of chance to practice this pool, honestly, which is a shame because I think the Hard Rock 2 and Free Mod 2 are some of the best maps I've seen in the pool. Free Mod 2, for example, I want to FC with Godak. That's like my favorite map I've ever seen. But anyways, I didn't get much time to practice a lot of maps because I was sick for most of this weekend. But when I played through Hidden 1 earlier, I was like, you know what, this one's not too bad. It's just like slightly more complicated No Mod 1 and it's fun. So I figure I can probably combo it. And then I did.
I know you guys both had the COVID buff or like the COVID shot buff, dude. That shit, that really, you guys had to reschedule from yesterday, so.
That shit killed me.
Yeah, so Will, Was, like, question to you. I had something in my mind, but.
Okay. Then I was gonna ask the same thing. You picked for HD 1, you stuck with HD even though you saw AMB go for no mod.
Yeah, well, so, like, knowing the rank difference, I kind of didn't expect to win too much, or like the match in whole. And I kind of just want to be able to practice for future matches. And, yeah. And I like it, and I'm just not very good at it, so it's kind of.
Yeah, it's a hard grind. When AMB fired up the I already hate doing this, I thought he was going to pick Hidden 2, I'm not going to lie. Because usually Hidden 1s are fine, but Hidden 2s are not everyone's favorite. That's when you start gawking, dude. That's when you fucking step out of the room.
Yeah, really. Yeah.
But yeah, I saw that. Yeah, you, Wasp, you fired out that you were happy with a couple of your performances, like Hard Rock 3, for example. And then right after, you kind of disappointed yourself with some other plays, dude.
I don't really know what happened. Like the Free Mod 1, I messed up. Well, I had like a whole paragraph in chat.
Yeah.
I messed up on that.
And then I think it was DT1 too. I don't know if you were kicking yourself. You stopped playing at the end, though. That's what I saw.
Yeah, well, so yeah, that one, I didn't actually stop playing. My pen fell out of my hand. So.
Oh, shit, dude.
But I don't think I would have won that one anyway, so I don't think it mattered, but that definitely bothered me. And then what map did we play after that? We played... Because the map after that, I really didn't feel good about either.
We went to DT1, and then it was Hidden 1 after. So, Hidden...
That was
just unfortunate, really, yeah.
Yeah, there's like a string of three maps that I just really felt I played bad on.
Yeah.
But the beginning of the match and the end of the match, I had a lot of fun.
Yeah, so. Free Mod 3, yeah, definitely gave us a heart attack there, you know? Do you guys feel anything when you guys saw how close you were on Free Mod 3 during the like the little pauses?
Isn't that right? Like, OMG.
Yeah.
I saw I was like, I think 40k behind, but I had like a fat combo. And that's when I started sweating a little bit. I'm like, okay, if I fuck this up, then I probably have to play Hidden 2 at some point. So I have to not.
Yeah.
If I had won Free Mod 3, I thought I had a good chance to win overall. But
yeah,
it didn't happen.
That's what close. I was thinking. That match is closer than like the 7-3 would tell you.
Yeah.
Because if you won that, I think you had a really good chance of winning either of the hidden picks because Hidden 1 was the only one that I could like actually kind of play. Mm-hmm. And then the DTs were really coin flip.
Yeah, DTs. Yeah. I was surprised you picked DT1 instead of DT3 because DT3 is speed 255, which after the Nomad 5 performance, it looked like it would be a teal deal for you, but you decided to go with DT1 instead, Ross.
Yeah, I literally was practicing streams before this, and I can't stream even like 160 today, so it wasn't worth it.
Yeah, you weren't gonna try double tapping your way to victory.
No, that'd be cheap.
Also, it looked like neither of you guys really enjoyed No Mod 5. That was a map. So
I apologize for picking that. That was so bad.
I think if I had spent more time practicing that one, I could have. Yeah. Done a little bit better than I did, but that was hard.
I saw MB playing and I'm like, oh, he's probably gonna not do that bad on it. And then I watched it in match. You guys were both just, I'm like, I almost kind of having second thoughts. I'm like, did I fuck up? Did I pick a bad map? But yeah.
I was messaging Will about it. I was like, damn, what's going on?
What I will say for clarification, I want to see what my scores on Nomad 1 were before.
Yeah.
It might have come off as like that one was maybe too hard for the pool because of how hard I griefed it. That is not the case. I just like that was such a complete fucking tragedy.
Yeah.
That happens every time.
That one was.
It happened to you on the last Nomad one too, and when you faced
Ikaria. I played it. I got like 200 something with 93%. I played it earlier and I had 400k with 97%.
Yeah.
So, not like amazing, but definitely way, way, way better than the score that I did in the match.
Yeah.
I just pure griefed that one. What was the miscount?
The only way I can really judge that Nomad one is if the next match tomorrow, 3MS versus DMGM, if they pick it, then that will really determine if that map is too fucking hard. Yeah, because I don't know. I thought the jumps were comfy when I pulled it, but it's shit happens, I guess. You make these mistakes, make these happy little mistakes, but yeah. Go ahead, Alan.
Both diffs that we were looking at, the one that had the lower star one was a lot slower. And like I couldn't, either way, I think people would have struggled.
Yeah.
With that map. So
Nomad ones are not, they're not fun maps. I hate Nomad ones, yes. Disgusting maps, dude. But yeah, I don't know if I have any other questions. What about you, Alan?
I don't have anything. Is there any last remarks you wanna say before we head off?
Any shout outs you guys wanna give and stuff?
Shout out to me next time we play for when I win.
Yeah, I'm excited. I like the attitude.
Alright. And what about you, AMV?
Shout outs to my, I think, three or so friends of mine in the chat that were hyping me up during like the last couple of matches. Love to see it.
Yeah. You got the hype there, you had the crowd there, so there's a tough crowd between both of you guys. You guys had your fans coming out just full force, so it was wild out there. There was a bit of mosh pit or whatever. But yeah, well, thanks for playing, guys. Heads bowed to Wasps for performing as well as you could. You had really good improvement throughout the whole tournament, dude. I respect that a lot. You kept your head high. It was just couldn't pass the final hurdle. It was shit happens. And then you also outperformed. You showed that you can play Hidden better than AMV, so
True, actually. I was autopiloting so hard during that tiebreaker. Like, first minute, I was kind of feeling it. Then the rest of it, I was just like, okay, I don't know what's going on. This is, like, boring.
Yeah. But, yeah. If you guys face again, that'll definitely be an exciting match. But, good luck. Good luck in your next match, AMV, where you're going to be facing one of the two demons. 3MS or DMGM.
So your
seeding is just so unlucky every time, dude. I swear to God. But yeah.
Is it going to be this pool or a different pool?
It'll be next pool, finals pool, which we have not finished yet, but we are in development.
Even higher star rating when I go against the demons. Very fun.
Yeah. Well, it'll be one. Y'all are your fans out there, dude. They're keeping you strong, but best of luck to you in that next match. And thanks to everybody who stopped by the stream. We'll see you next time.